Welcome back, or welcome if you're new. This is SAP Developer News.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. Andre Fischer is back in the news again this week. He has shared with us an ABAP programming model feature availability matrix. In this latest blog post, Andre shows us a feature comparison between the SAP Gateway OData frameworks, V2 and V4, the ABAP programming model for SAP Fiori, and of course the ABAP RESTful application programming model in both on-premise and the SABTP ABAP environment. He also provides some links for additional reading of all the ABAP programming models mentioned in the matrix. Check out Andre's blog post for more information.
This week, we received the July 2021 update to the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model. As always, you can refer to the complete release notes, which we link to in the description of this video. But let's highlight a few of the key enhancements in this release. First of all, we have the expanded support for TypeScript. In particular, there is a CDS-TS CLI command that you can now use instead of the CDS serve or CDS watch commands. This command avoids having to pre-compile the TypeScript files to JavaScript each time you want to test and helps speed up the whole development testing process. On the subject of command line, the CDS CLI also now offers a best guess if you use a command that isn't known. And the CDS import command has also been enhanced to now support documents of OData V4 in addition to OData V2. And we have a new command, CDS add data, which creates CSV files with header lines for the entities in your project. On the modeling side of CAP, we have the introduction of dynamic expressions in the Fiori annotations, and the ability to now define views that have the exist predicate. On the samples and learning materials side, we also have the introduction of the new end-to-end tutorials in developers.sap.com and a brand new sample application available in GitHub that translates the famous ABAP S-Flight travel reference application to CAP. In particular, the sample focuses on SAP Fiori annotations and helps you compare features between CAP Node.js, CAP Java, and ABAP Wrap. Once again, this is just a little flavor of all the new goodies in this month's CAP release, and the full notes can be found in the online documentation, linked to in the description of this video.
The Q2 update of SAP HANA Cloud is now available for all customers, including users of trial accounts. This release brings a number of improvements in areas of availability, migration, administration, security. One such improvement is a new integration of SAP HANA Cloud into the BTP Alert Notification Service. You can use the ANS to collect and distribute alerts created by the database service via multiple channels. Please check the new tutorial to practice this integration. Developers among us should find especially interesting some new possibilities in smart multimodal processing. Here are top three I know have been requested by many of you. First, SAP HANA Graph now supports heterogeneous network data. It means different vertex types containing different attributes and different edge types. Second, SAP HANA Spatial allows now the null value to be assigned in place of a spatial reference ID or SRID when you are creating a table. Each insert statement has to contain the SRID of the inserted geometry. It means different rows can have different SRIDs in the same column now. Third, in SAP HANA Doc Store, JSON documents can be imported from and exported to files. There were numerous updates in the functionality of the embedded machine learning in both predictive analytics and automated prediction libraries. For all the details, please check the What's New page in SAP HANA Cloud documentation. And please remember that your database upgrade in SAP HANA Cloud is as simple as a single click, and the upgrade process takes just a few minutes. Enjoy!
The SAP BTP SDK for iOS team has created a brand new open source repository for you. The project is a SwiftUI implementation of the augmented reality, short AR, patterns. The controls provided through the API follows the SAP Fiori for iOS design guidelines and are thought for business use cases. With the combination of Apple's Reality Composer and the SAP Fiori for iOS AR Kit, the possibility for AR-ready apps are brought to you by the SDK team. The repository is in its early stages and currently under development. You can still visit the repository, contribute through open source, and use the available controls and APIs via the Swift Package Manager. So try out the AR Kit capabilities today.
This has been a big week for SAP Cloud Application Programming Model news. Earlier in this news program, we told you about the July 2021 release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model and all the enhancements and new features it contains. Now we also want to showcase some of the community contributions from, and I hope I'm pronouncing this right, Jörg Heigl. Jörg has been busy in the community Q&A, on the hands-on SAP Devs live stream, and in the recent recap conference. And just this week, he was also sharing a very interesting blog post about custom authentication in the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model with social logons. He's pushing the boundaries of the typical use cases for SAP Cloud Application Programming Model and really broadening what's possible by not just describing what could be done, but also showing people how to achieve what he's talking about. In this blog post, he not only builds a demo that uses Vue.js and Tailwind with a CAP backend and authentication using a GitHub OAuth ID, he also shares the high-level steps in the blog, but then also the source code to the complete demo is released open source on GitHub. So if you want to learn from a community member doing impressive things and pushing the envelope with both Cloud Application Programming Model and Fiori topics, we'd recommend that you follow Jörg on the SAP community and keep an eye out for what he's sharing.
Some of you may know that this week saw a fun race to see who would be first to reach a milestone. A year-to-date kilometer milestone for me and an SAP Developers YouTube channel subscribers milestone for you. And I'm happy to report that I lost and you won. We're delighted to share that over 10,000 of you already value what we share enough to subscribe. And it makes a lot of sense because when you subscribe, you get notified of new content straight away and can be one of the first to see that content. And if you haven't subscribed already, what's stopping you? Head over to the SAP Developers YouTube channel and hit that big red button. It doesn't cost you anything and it makes a lot of sense. See you on YouTube.